Hi guys, I have prepared this tutorial for beginners who are using CAD for the first time. Let's get started. For the first part, we will learn about making the basic drawing. Now, when you start AutoCAD for the very first time, this is how your window looks like. And it also depends on the software which you are using and its version. Now, there are two different software of CAD with complete version, which is called Autodesk AutoCAD, available in different version, and I am using 2017. And the second one, Autodesk LT. This version is the lighter version of AutoCAD with limited set of features. The basic features are simple in both software, but some advanced features are not available in LT. Okay, let's start our drawing. We have different templates which are already inbuilt in AutoCAD. We are using this template acad.dwt, and for the next we have to just click on start drawing. It will start a new tab. Now, as you see, we have different parts of the screen. The first one is the application button on the top left, which has all the frequently used tools. In the top left have some quick access toolbars. And then we have the tabs called ribbon right below the application tools like home, insert, annotate, and so on. And on this tab we have panels, and on these panels we have tools and the commands. To activate any tool, we just have to click on tool or give a command. For example, if we draw a circle, we just have to click on circle and draw. And for command, we have to put the command. That is C for circle, which is also a shortcut. Then press enter to activate the tool. Now this is the drawing area on which everything is actually drawn in AutoCAD. And then we have the command bar right below the drawing area. And then finally we have the status bar and the workspace switching menu, which help us making drawings. We have navigation bar on our right side of drawing area, which help us to navigate our drawing. And this cross is our mouse indicator, and it has exactly this shape when we don't have any command active. Okay, let's start our very first drawing quickly. For that, we have to go on line tool and click on it. Now you see that after activating the command, the two intersecting lines, this type of cursor is called point cursor. Right next to the cursor, you will see this kind of bar called dynamic input toolbar. If you don't have, that's fine. You can bring it using F12 function. And also you can disappear it with the same function. Right now I am not using this bar, so I will make it disappear. Now we have this empty cursor. As we can see, we have clear instruction on command bar, which is saying specify first point. Now we click at the point, and that will be our first point. Now click on another. That is the second point, then third, fourth, and fifth. Now, as you see, we have our command active. To deactivate the command or finish our drawing, press enter. Now, here we have the very first drawing. Okay. Next, we will start with our basic optional setting for our display. For that, you have to put the command OP for options and press enter. Our new window will appear like this. As you see, we have different options in this. We will start with display. In display setting, first thing we have is window elements, in which we have options for color scheme, dark and light. Mostly people use dark, and right below, some other options for display is given, which you can set according to yourself, like layout elements, display resolution, display performance, crosshair size. Crosshair is basically our cursor in AutoCAD, and then we have fade controls. Then the next is open and save. In this, the important setting we have to do is to select the version of CAD for your drawing. Then we move to plot and publish, which I will guide you later. And then we have some other settings which you can set according to you. After selection, you have to apply the setting and then press enter. These are the basic settings which you set once after installing the AutoCAD. Or you can set again if you want later. So now let's talk about the navigation tool. So here we have this simple rectangle. Now if you want to navigate in your drawing, if you want to move this drawing around, then you can do that using your middle mouse wheel. So in AutoCAD, it is recommended to use three button mouse, the left click, right click in the middle mouse wheel. This button should be there, and to move this drawing, all you need to do is press and hold the middle mouse wheel. And when you do that, your cursor will change to this hand icon. Now move the drawing. Rotate your mouse wheel, it will zoom in your drawing. In opposite direction, it will zoom out. Also, the point where you put your cursor will become the point which will be zoomed in or zoomed out. To select anything in your drawing, all you need to do is just click on it and that object will be selected. To deselect anything, press escape key and it will deselect your selection, or it will just remove everything from your selection set. Now before moving on, I'm going to make another drawing here. I will just make a circle. So I will go to circle, I will click at a point and I will click that another point. So now we have a circle, we have a rectangle and a circle. So if you want to select anything in AutoCAD, as I mentioned earlier, you can't select it using this left click. So move your cursor over the boundary and left click, it will be selected. That's easy. But if you have lots of objects in your drawing and if you want to select all, click at a point and let go your cursor. Then move your mouse to the right and you are going to get this window. This solid window is called selection window, and everything which is completely inside this window will be selected. In this case, the circle is selected as it is completely inside this window. Now if I click here and I will move to this side, I am going to get this window which is the solid window, and everything which is inside the window will be selected. Now the second window is crossing window, and for this click, let go your cursor, don't click and hold your cursor, just click and let go. Now move your mouse to the left and you are going to get this dashed window, which is also called the crossing window. In this case, any object which even touches the boundary of this crossing window will be selected. So in this case, the circle and the three lines of the rectangle, they are simply touching it, not they are completely inside. And if you click, they will still be selected like this. So I will press escape to get rid of this selection. And then we have third kind of selection set, which is called the lasso selection. So press and hold your left click. Now move your mouse and you are going to get this kind of lasso selection. So if you press and hold, you will get this selection. If you press your left click, let go, and you will get this window selection in blue. Now let's move to the unit. So for that, I will delete this drawing, so I will make the window and delete. Before you begin any drawing, the first and the basic thing that you will want to do is set the proper units. To set the unit, type UN, and if you type anything in AutoCAD, it will always type that in command line. You don't need actually to click here in the command line and then type anything. You just need to start typing and it will type the commands directly here. On the command lines, so I have got units UN. I will press enter to N, and if you type anything in AutoCAD, it will always type that in command line. You don't need actually to click here in the command line and then type anything. You just need to start typing and it will type the commands directly here. On the command lines, so I have got units UN. I will press enter and the drawing units window will pop up. Now, here we have the unit option. It is right now set to millimeters. I will change to 8 inches. You can select from any of these units. Now, for the length, if you want a proper feet and inch format, you can select architecture. And now you will get your drawing in the form of feet and inches. And now in this case, if you type 4, it will be 4 inches. If you type 5, it will be 5 inches. But if you type 12, it will now change to 1 feet, which is obviously equal to 12 inches. So you can directly type the inch value, or you can also type the feet values in this architectural format. So for now, I will go to architectural. I will click on OK. And now we are using inches and feet. Now let's talk about making the first set of drawing, and we will do that using line tool. So you can click here to select the line command, or you can also use its command L. So I will type L and press enter to start the command. Now we need to start from a point. As you can see here, the instruction says you need to start from point. So I will just click here, and now I will move my cursor to the right. When you do that, AutoCAD will show you the bar on which you will see the approximate length of the line. Let's make a line of 10 inches. So I am going to type 10 and press enter. And we will have a line of length 10 inches, which is pretty tiny here. So let's zoom in. Now I will move it to the top and then I will type 5 and enter. And we have the second line of length 5. Then you can again go to the left side or any other direction which you want. Put the value, for example, maybe 20 and enter. You can even align it in any direction if you want. So I am going to align it here. I will type 30, enter, and so on. So you can keep on making your lines by entering the proper distances, and it will just make your line that way. Also, in this case, if you want to add angle values, then that also you can do pretty easily. So in this case, let's just make another line length 20. So I am going to type 20, and now from here I want it to incline at an angle of exactly 30 degrees. So now instead of typing 30, I am going to type this angle sign. Now this angle sign is on your keyboard. It's right next to the M key. So just press shift key, press and hold shift key, and then press the angle sign key, and it will add the angle sign. Now type in 30 and press enter. And AutoCAD will now take this value as angle, not as distance. So if you move your cursor, now you are going to see angle override here, which is now set to 30 unit. So if you now move your cursor, the length will change here, but not the angle. So all you need to do is now type in the length. So maybe I will try 10, enter, and here it is now. The length of this line is 10 and it is inclined to an angle of 30 degrees. Now to exit the command, press enter key, and this was the line tool. In this case, I specified the angle right here using the command line. But there is also a tool on workstation called polar tracking. You can select your angle from here, like I am using 10, and then while drawing, you can see a green line which will help you indicate angle of 10 and multiples of 10. And after using again your angles, you have to select back 90 degree. Now you can also force your lines to 90 degree angles or the multiple of 90s. Using this tool, this is auto mode. If you select this, AutoCAD will only let you make your drawings at the multiple of 90 degrees. So now, if I click here, I will be able to make line here horizontal or vertical. I won't be able to make my line in any other direction. So look at this, no matter where my cursor is, I will still end up with horizontal or vertical lines just because of ortho mode. So I will switch back to polar tracking and the ortho mode will automatically disable now. And you can also see angles indicate on dynamic input bar. Now let's talk about the object snap status bar option. And without using object snap, you won't be able to make precise drawings. So whenever you select any command or move your cursor close to any point, for example, in this case, I am moving close to these intersection points, also called the end point. To those point, and you will also see this tooltip with endpoint and this green box. So this is happening because we have object snap activated here. And on the object snap, if you click on this arrow, you will see list of points. We have endpoint, midpoint, center, intersection and insertion selected. So currently only this point will show up. When you bring your cursor close to any point, in this case, look at the midpoint, it is now appeared. It will just uncheck this. I will go to this point. We have point here and I will just click here. And now I will move my cursor close to the midpoint of this line. But look at this, we don't have anything. Now, even if I click here, which is very close to the midpoint, look at my drawing, it will snap the line to this point because this was highlighted. It won't snap to midpoint. I will go to this object snap and I will activate midpoint. Also make sure that this tool is also active here. On your status bar, this should be checked now. If I go to midpoint, look at this, it will be highlighted. And if we show the midpoint, so now we can clearly click like this. So this is the object snap. Now other points in object snap include the center. If I move close to the center of an arc or circle, it will recognize that other points are the intersection point. For example, if I go here, it will recognize the intersection of these two lines or any other curve. And so on. If you deactivate object snap, you won't be able to snap to these points. And look at this, even if I move close to this point, it won't recognize. No endpoint, no midpoint. So it should be checked if you want these points. Now you know the basic of making lines. In next video, we will move to modify tools. Thank you.